So it's a Trini Christmas, your table is full, but your glass is empty. What better way to fill it than with some nice cold sorrow made just right? Hi guys, I'm Erica of Erica's Joyful Oven, and today I'm sharing with you guys how I make my sorrel for Christmas. So making sorrel isn't an exact science. You can use red sorrel or black sorrel, and they're both going to taste delicious, and they're both prepared more or less the same. To begin, we're going to clean the sorrel by taking out the seeds. Very carefully cut a ring at the top of the sorrel, give it a little twist and the seed will pop right out. I'm wearing gloves because the surface of the seeds are a little bit prickly, so I find that the gloves makes this process a little bit quicker and easier. Wash the sorrel to get rid of any dirt or residue. I have 1 pound of clean black sorrel and I'm going to add enough water to just barely cover the sorrel. I'm using 7 cups of water in total. A good average is that to every pound of clean sorrel, you want to add 1 cinnamon stick and 4 to 6 cloves. I'm using only 4 whole cloves because I find that they're really nice and fragrant. I'll place this on the stove on a high heat for about 10 minutes and when it comes to a boil, reduce the heat and let it simmer for 30 to 40 minutes until it's nice and fragrant. So my house officially smells like Christmas and you can see that as the sorrel has finished boiling, the water has turned a really bright red color and the pulp has turned a pale red. Let the sorrel cool until it's just warm and easier to handle. And next we're going to remove the pulp using a fine strainer, a sieve or even a cheesecloth, and we're going to squeeze out all of those liquids, all of that nice sorrel juice out of the pulp. You can even add some extra water to the pulp and squeeze it just to make sure that you've gotten all of that delicious flavor out of the pulp. And lastly, I'm going to add a sweetener to the sorrel while it's still warm. I'll add in 1/2 cup of granulated sugar at a time, mixing each addition until it's well dissolved. If you add the sugar while the sorrel is cool, the granules will take longer to dissolve and it's highly likely that the sorrel is going to turn out too sweet if you continue adding extra sugar before all has dissolved. In total, I've added just about 2 cups of sugar and all of the granules are dissolved and it's the perfect taste for my liking. You can add a little more or less depending on your taste, and if you find the mixture is too concentrated, add just a little water at a time until you've gotten that perfect sorrel taste. My sorrel tastes amazing. I'm going to strain it again into a glass pitcher and set it in the refrigerator until it's nice and chilled. And now you can pour that perfect glass of sorrel for this Christmas season. The cinnamon and cloves might seem like a simple addition, but they perfectly complement the natural flavor and sweetness in the sorrel. This tall glass of sorrel will pair so well with some pastels, ham, and even a slice of black cake. My family loves that crisp taste and the warm spices, and I know that you and your family will enjoy this as well this Christmas season. You guys know I love hearing from you all, so if you try this recipe, let me know in the comments below what you think. And be sure to like and subscribe to Erica's Joyful Oven on Facebook and YouTube for more amazing recipes. Bye guys!